Hey y'all, so the other night when the water got really bad, I knew where a beaver was hemmed up at, and I know where he'd been staying, and I know when that water got up above his dam, that he was going to come out there. So I just happened to set a leg trap in one of his slides, and sure enough, they're a creature of habit. They'll follow them slides every time, and sure enough, I just happened to pick the right one, and just picked the one that's wore out the most, figured that's the one he was using at the moment. Bingo. As you can see behind me, I got it. Now he does have a pretty gruesome injury, and we're going to try to skin him out here, so let's see what we can do with him.
So the leg trap didn't kill him, and he gave himself a pretty gruesome injury there, as you can see, jerking and things on that leg trap, but I end up putting him out when I got to him. Very humane.
First thing we're going to do is brush him out a little bit.
Basic square fur on this, so I'm not going to try to do nothing fancy with it. I'm basically wanting the back and the belly, that's it.
I'm going to start right there with that injury. Basically make your ring around each leg. You can see it's a male beaver. We're just gonna come right below there. Straight over to her other cut. I put that little hole where in the hole to it. just gonna take and square him up best we can.
So we got him washed up and everything, and we're gonna cut him to fit this board I've got here. And, I'll show you how we're going about putting him on there and stretching him out. Take the part with the staples and square it off and cut it out. Turn the finger hole.
caught the hook out of. Again, I told you in the coon video, if you're gonna take a fur to trade, don't salt it, don't put borax, don't do nothing to it. Don't add no additives to it, your process.
Got that one homework, but I can straighten that off first. Some big deal. There's something laying around real pretty. That's where it all off in the end.
For those of y'all who've never seen a beaver, I want you to check this creature out, right? Which I know he's skin out and it's a little gruesome, but he's got these big old feet, web feet that he uses for paddles. Dig through the dirt and swim on the bottom and all this. He's got this big old scaly tail, which is just about pure leather. And in some places, they get big dollars for those. I don't know what they do with them or whatnot, but they do. They give a lot of money for them. Like I say, I don't know exactly what they do or whatever, but it's a gnarly tail. And this is a big old beaver, probably 50 pounder. Check out those feet, though. Big old web feet. You talk about doing some swimming. This cat here could do her. And that big old tail. And the way he scares predators is he'll smack his tail off the water. That's the way he scares off predators. Now, I know this is a little gruesome. Check out his hardware up here. Check out them big gnarly teeth. When you see all these trees that's been chewed into, that's what's doing.
Hey guys, we appreciate your support, all the liking, the sharing, the subscribing. Really happy with where it's going. Remember again, we just went through the big flood, the ice storm. Please keep my community in your prayers and your thoughts. And it's just been a hard time, but hope you like this tonight. It's something new I tried, new for me, but So when I was doing all this, cleaning the beaver, I got thinking about an old story one time an old timer told me a long time ago about how beavers, once they find a mate, they'll stay together for a lifetime, you know, in love, and never leave one another unless one of them's killed or whatnot. And believe it or not, I kind of got to feeling a little guilty about taking the big old male. That's big as they get, and I'm sure he's fathered a lot of little ones. But I also found out a lot of other fun facts about beavers that I just wanted to share. Back in the ice age, these things used to grow up to 8 feet tall. It's just simply amazing to me, and it's wild how beavers would have been that big back then. But everything was bigger then. Also, the scientific name for a beaver is castor, and they put out an oil that's called castrum that is sometimes used in vanilla extract flavor that we eat as humans. And that was a new one on me, but and also their scientific name, their castor, that's where the old saying comes from, "I'll castrate you," because back in the old days, there was a myth going around that male beavers would bite off their own testicles and castrate themselves to keep hunters from wanting them for the castor oil. Just a myth. How it got started, I don't know, but it was there. I don't know what else we'll look here, but I just thought them few there was simply amazing. Here's the one I was talking about. Beavers are romantic, or at least they're monogamous. Dams are usually started by a young male looking for love, or by a mated for life new couple. A whole beaver family will live in a single dam, a mom, a dad, and young kids, and yearlings. So the old timer was right on that. Another thing that I thought was really cool about beavers is that they'll flood an area, right? Well, the reason they do that is they want it deep enough to where it won't freeze over, because what happens is they store their food under the water. So little saplings and stuff, they'll go under the water and make a pile of food there for when they need it. I just thought that was cool. But, guys, I just wanted to, you know, give you a few fun facts about them. You know, I hope you get something from a little amusement like I do. But I just want to do that and, you know, keep in mind, if you kill one beaver, you separating the whole family. Well, guys, appreciate you. There's your fun facts.